Postseason baseball on the show is in full swing. It's game three of the National League Championship Series between the Chicago Cubs and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vasgersian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of baseball on the show. With me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, lots to talk about here as we get ready for game three.
And when you start the series on the road, obviously, you'd love to win two games. But coming out of there with no worse than a split is what you're really kind of hoping to accomplish. So now, they come home, they've taken back home field advantage, and they can feed on this crowd, hopefully, to give them a big leg up in this series.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Crowd is ready to erupt as their guys get set to take the field. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now your 2016 Los Angeles Dodgers.
Quickly now, we'll look at the two guys who'll get the ball here in game three. We'll hear more from the guys as the night moves along, but first, let's take a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Chicago Cubs, as Joe Maddon will line them up like this. And on the mound to face these guys, there you see the numbers for the veteran southpaw, Rich Hill. And behind him defensively, the Dodgers will line up like this. Dexter Fowler will stand in, and this pitching staff has kept his bat silent throughout the series so far.
Yeah, just two hits for him so far, but you've got to figure he's due. I don't think they're going to hold him down all series long.
And we're underway here tonight, and it'll be a good start in that visiting dugout as this is into center field for a leadoff single. Javier Baez digs in, ready for his first plate appearance. At a curveball there. No balls and a strike. And he'll step off and fire to the bag. And he'll dive back in safely. Comes set. Now the pitch. Chased a low ball there, and he's quickly down in the count 0-2.
Now he's probably lucky he didn't make contact on that one.
To slowly hit the short, probably too slowly to get two. He turns and goes to second, and they do get the out there.
Kind of lucky to get an out anywhere here. You see the off-balance throw to second base, and it doesn't have a whole lot of zip on it, but they do find a way to get that force.
In now, Chris Bryant. As he gets under the first pitch and sends a fly ball out to a right field. And the catch made out there by Ethier, and that's out number two. Anthony Rizzo We'll dig in now, and he's picked the wrong time of year for his bat to go silent.
Yeah, just one hit in the series so far for him, and they're going to have to get more out of his bat. But he's got to make sure he doesn't press up there, or that average is going to continue to go south.
First pitch of the at-bat is lifted in the air out to left. Reddick is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Cubs strand one. And now a look at the starting lineup for the host Dodgers. They'll match up against a guy trying to put it all together, the right-hander Jake Arrieta. A look at the defensive alignment for the Cubs here. Andre Ethier comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Corner for strike one. Figure we'll probably see a heavy dose of that sinker here tonight.
It's really a pitch he'll lean on, especially when he needs that ground ball, but even in situations like this where he's just trying to get ahead.
And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first down. Josh Reddick is ready for his first AB here in this one. Power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. Now the 0-1 is swung on and grounded the other way to third. Throw gets him, two down. Corey Seager will stand in now for the first time, coming off, well, nothing short of a dynamic performance last time out.
Well, it makes you wonder how they're going to attack him here in this game. I would bet that they're a lot more cautious with him.
This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Now the pitch. And a pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. And the throw from shallow right in time at first, and the inning will come to an end. 1-2. Chris Coughlin will take his cuts now, and he is one guy whose bat has not made the transition from regular season to postseason.
Yeah, and he was so good during the regular year, but he's been a non-factor so far in this postseason.
Front as this is in the air toward deep right field. And it's a fly out to start the second, one away. So the base is empty here with one away, and set to go now is the shortstop Ben Zobrist. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1.
Yeah, when Matt's upstairs like that, that's a pitch you've got to leave alone and make him bring something down.
And that is through into center field for a one-out single.
You talk about getting a bat head out in front. This is rifled up the middle. Can't square up a baseball any better than that.
As a look, now the pitch. First pitch of the AB is swung on and lifted in the air to straightaway center. Peterson is there now, and he has it, two gone. Cenk Arrieta steps in. He'll get his first shot at it here. He's ready now. The pitch. Swing and a liner. And he's got himself a base hit. Oh, and he botches it. So some real problems out there that time as it'll wind up in E7. Number 40 will get his first cuts here. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. That's in there. Base hit. Now a good throw in will hold that second runner at third base, so they're at the corners now with two away. Dexter Fowler gets a shot now with deuces all around. Two on, two out here in inning number two. Pause, now the pitch. Oh, had him chopping at that one. It's nothing and one.
Well, it's so important to be able to strike first in a postseason game. Get that first run in, especially when you're the team playing on the road. Hopefully you can take a little life out of this big crowd.
And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. He's set, now the pitch. And that is through into center field, a base hit. And that'll score the run from third as they go up 2-0 now. Javier Baez steps into the box and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home in the inning so far. Comes set, now the pitch. And this is hit hard on the ground towards short. He'll send it the short way to Utley at second, and that's that. So two runs on four hits here, one Dodger error, and a couple of men left. We'll go to the Justin Turner will get his shot now. Great power numbers during the regular season. Still searching for that first home run in the postseason, however.
And these guys really need him to start producing because it seems like pitchers have the upper hand in the postseason. You're always facing the other team's best. And they've pretty well neutralized him all October long.
Fastball called for strike two. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. So one away here with the bases empty. And stepping in now, the slugging first baseman, Adrian Gonzalez. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now the pitch. One and two now.
Yeah, it's so hard to stay back against a guy like this. Unless you guess right, that thing's just so slow that it's almost impossible to keep from getting out on your front foot.
Jock Peterson stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
Trying to jump on that first pitch changeup. That's a good pitch there to start this AB.
Now a swing as he shoots this one over to first. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Dodgers down in order. Chris Bryant is into the box as we are all set to begin the third.
Chris Bryant.
Big curveball swung on and missed, 0-1. Not the greatest at-bat thus far as he misses that pitch in the dirt and falls behind nothing and two now.
Oh, yeah, you know, he went backdoor breaking ball with the previous pitch. Then he's got him set up to come down and in with the next one, and he throws a pearl right there.
Batting.
Anthony Rizzo is at the plate now. Flied out at his first at bat. And a foul tip held onto here at strike one. A runner at first with no outs here. A lot of movement that time. It's 0-2. A lot of pitches up in the zone here early on.
And that's not the worst thing in the world at this place, but you've got to pick your spots.
Ooh, tough to lay off there, but it's called a ball, 1-2. And struck him out.
Well, this curveball, it just disappears. He thinks he's right on it at the plate. And look where it winds up, completely out of the zone. That's what you want as a pitcher. You want hitters to chase pitches that aren't strikes.
Chris Coughlin will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one.
And after that call, you know he's got to be turning around to say something like, hey, you know what? This guy doesn't need any help. He's good.
And he'll dive back in. Here's a hard hit ball back up the middle. Step on the bag for one. Over to Gonzalez, and they get the double play they needed to get him out of the inning. One hit's all they get. Shea Sutley will come forward to begin the inning. 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
They're still searching for a base run. It's been 6 up, 6 down to start the game.
Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Swing and a grounder fouled off to the left. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike. Strike 2 called, and it's even at 2.
A little conviction behind that fastball.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. Here's another 2-2. And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seats, so we'll have to do it again. Still 2-2. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now a fastball is lifted into the air to shallow center. Fowler comes on now, and he has it, 1 down. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And stepping in is the catcher, Carlos Ruiz. Here it comes. And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one. Here's one fouled off to the right as the count evens at 1-1. Dodgers have yet to break into the hit column here. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
Oh, and this is swung on and missed. 4 strikeouts already, and that's out number 2. Rich Hill will stand in now with 2 away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Yeah, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Wow, he is spotting that fastball on a dime here early on.
And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Ben Zobrist is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
Shortstop, Ben Zobrist.
Now here's the pitch. And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one.
Yeah, he's not really getting on top of that curveball right now. That's going to get him into trouble if he keeps leaving it up there like that.
Hey! in the air to right center. And Ethier is able to look this one in for the first down.
Jorge Soler
is into the box for his second appearance. 0-for-1 with a flyout. Now here it comes. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. He sends it out to left field. Well hit. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. A solo shot here to left. His first homer here in the series. And the Cubs have taken a 3-0 lead.
And this is just a fastball right here, but I'm pretty sure it's not where he wanted it. This has got some elevation to it, and that's one of those where you know it's going to be a home run as soon as you let go of it.
Into the box now, Jake Arrieta.
Jake Arrieta.
Foul tip into the catcher's glove at strike one. That home run a moment ago, 407 feet officially. Tony breaks out the hook here, good for strike two.
Ah, and if my math is good, that's a 19-mile-an-hour differential between those two pitches. It's very tough to adjust to that pitch right there.
Base hit.
The batter, number 40.
Number 40 steps in with one in, one out, and one on here in the inning. He waits. Now the pitch. Taken the other way, but this should be routine out there in right field. Waiting on it is Ethier, and Andre puts it away for out number two. Dexter Fowler will dig in again. He singled home a run his last time. From the stretch. Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one. Now a ball hit back up the middle. And a gorgeous flip to second. And with that, the side is retired. Cubs tack on another courtesy of this solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's 3-0 Chicago. Andre Ethier will stand in to begin their half of the fourth, with his guys still looking for their first hit of the ballgame.
Yeah, still looking for their first base runner, too. Nine up, nine down.
Swing and a line drive, but foul. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Josh Reddick stands in. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out. Chopper foul. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. He pops up the changeup, heading out towards shallow right. Here's Baez to make the catch, and that becomes out number two. Corey Seager digs in with his team still looking at a zero in the hit column. Pitch on the way. Fastball in there for a called strike. Ooh, he saws him off with that one. And he'll avoid the fragments out there to make the catch that ends the inning. Dodgers down in order. They trail it here 3-0. Javier Baez heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Second baseman, Javier Baez.
Now here's the pitch. Now a swing and a ground ball. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Some action in the Dodger bullpen now as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. Off the plate, one ball, one strike.
Even though he's given up his share of hits so far, he still hasn't walked anybody, so at least he's got that going for him.
And he chased one there as this is bounced to short. Oh, and he throws it away. Chris Bryant will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. He's ready. Now the pitch. Now a ball lined toward right center. And that is going to be a base hit. Oh, and he can't come up with it. Around third and being waved on home. And this will not be close, and the run will score easily.
And this might be a situation where a little time in the video room pays off. They know this is a guy that'll throw that curveball early in the count, so it looked like he was waiting for it. He'll drive and run here on the double.
Brandon McCarthy is going to take over here in inning number five, as it's going to be up to their bullpen to try and keep them in the game here. Anthony Rizzo will be the first one to greet him here, as he'll be doing so with a runner in scoring position and still nobody out. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Smack the opposite way now, and this should give him at least two bases. Around third and being waved on home. And they'll add another, as this is now a 5-0 game. And he will pull into second with an RBI double. Chris Coughlin will dig in. He's flown out and hit into a double play in two trips. From the belt, kicks and deals. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Swing and a miss, and he's in the hole 0-2 now. The early hit total, about what you'd expect in a score line such as this. Hit hard on the ground is short. And he's retired one away. Ben Zobrist digs in now with two already home and a potential third waiting in the wings only 90 feet away. He's ready now. The pitch. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw from shallow right will get him at first, but the run will come in to score. Jorge Soler steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And now a pitch on the way. Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. So three runs on only two hits in the inning, one error in the inning, and no one left on base. Justin Turner will stand in to lead things off here. And his guys have been unable to get anything going to this point.
Yeah, and you think so many times in the postseason, we see starting pitching really come to the forefront. And this guy's been every bit as good as advertised so far.
First pitch sinker misses in on the hands that time. It's a ball and no strikes. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. No problem here. One away.
Yep, another good job right there to get that first out. And you can pretty much bet he's probably thinking to himself, anytime my boys get me six runs of support, I think we're going to be okay. This is a pretty tough hole to climb out of now.
Adrian Gonzalez stands in as he looks at a called strike.
Boy, he has been a first strike throwing machine, hasn't he? He's hardly been behind in the count all game long.
And there's a swing and a miss as Adrian finds himself in an 0-2 hole now. Just a touch outside, 1-2. Zobrist now at short. Throw right there, and that takes care of Gonzalez. Two gone now. A look at our line score to this point, and I'm almost certainly jinxing things by pointing it out, but it's worth mentioning that zero in the hit column through two outs here in the fifth. Now the pitch. Jock Peterson is in with two away here as this one swung on and missed for the first strike.
Well on his way to another good inning right here, and you see the pitch count. It's not even close to being a factor just yet.
And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Jake Arrieta comes to the plate now, likely due to the large cushion he has to work with on the scoreboard. Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. In there, 0-1. Good cut fastball that time, and he's in control now, 0-2. Here it comes. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning. Number 40 stands in.
Number 40.
The pitch. Sinker runs outside to start the at-bat, 1-0. Hit well down the left field line, but back into the crowd, foul. And the pitch. Now here's a swing and a ball hit well out there toward right center. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. Around second, he'll try for third. And he'll get in there safely.
Well, here you go one more time. This ball's going to split the defenders out there in right center. And he's thinking three pretty much right out of the gate. So he cruises around second and makes it up to third with a triple.
Bonds, now the pitch. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Six runs, 11 hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Big swing there as it's hit pretty well out toward deep left field. Catch made by Reddick, and here comes the runner from third. And he will score on the sacrifice fly.
Well, you know, he needed to make sure that he could cash in on that one-out triple. And the sacrifice fly is going to get the job done. That's a good piece of hitting.
Javier Baez will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. Now the pitch. Oh, missed that one by a mile. It's 0-1. That look says it all in the third base dugout.
That's not the look of a guy who's going to be sleeping well tonight, is it?
And this will be fouled away. Two out, nobody on. Swing and a bouncing ball back up the middle. Throw will go to Adrian at first, and with it, the side is retired. So one run here on one hit, no errors, and no one left. Chase Utley gets things started here in the sixth for the hometown team. Here's the pitch.
Chase Utley.
Bottom three in the batting order here as the first pitch misses to the number seven hitter. It's ball one. And that swung on and fouled straight back. That one finds the target on the outer half. It's 1-2.
And that has been the comfort zone so far in this outing. He's just lived on that outside corner, and it's paid big dividends for him.
Zobrist now at short. Throws in time, and that's out number one. Carlos Ruiz comes to the plate looking to put the ball in play. He went down on strikes last time. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
And I wish more guys would pitch like this. I mean, look at that pitch count right there. That is really low for this stage of the game, and It's because he's throwing strikes and challenging guys.
Howie Kendrick will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now.
Yeah, and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. And this is fouled back and out of play. Struck him out, so it might be time to begin the countdown as he's now gone through six innings without allowing a base hit. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. J.P. Howell will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Chris Bryant ready for another at-bat now. He's 2-for-3 so far. Breaking ball, it's cut on and missed for the first strike. Good curveball that time in the low 80s, nothing in two. Now here's the pitch. And he reaches for one out of the zone and misses rather badly for the first out. Anthony Rizzo gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. And now a pitch on the way. And here's a ball hit in the air. Seager takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out.
Popping it up is bad enough, but doing it on the first pitch, you know, and out of the zone to boot, I mean, this just is not a good AB. I can tell you that.
Now the pitch. Chris Coughlin stands in as he looks at ball one here. Now here's the pitch. Out in front as this is in the air toward deep right field. Ethier is under this one. And that will retire the side. Cubs are down in order. And they hold a 7-0 lead. Andre Ethier will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. And that's on the outside corner for a strike.
Another good pitch there. I'm not sure he's thrown a bad slider tonight. Every one of them has had a ton of movement.
And he strikes him out here. So that's out number one here in the seventh as he continues to keep him out of the hit column. Josh Reddick will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. In there, and it's 0-1.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still hearing the catcher's mitt snapping all the way up here.
Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Reddick waiting, and now the pitch. Got him. So that's the second out of the inning, and he's seven outs away now. Corey Seager will get his third shot at it here. He's bounced out and popped out in his previous two trips. The pitch. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Not the first time he's felt the squeeze tonight.
Yeah, he's looking and saying, what do I got to do to get a strike?
And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now. Swing and a miss on the heater, and it's 2-1. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
And he's struck him out to retire the side, so he's through seven complete, still working on a masterpiece. Ben Zobrist comes to the plate, and he'll start us off in the eighth. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground to short. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. So with one gone here in the top of the eighth, even the home fans are starting to sense that we could be on the verge of witnessing history as we get a look at our line score here, and you see the big number. No hit for the home team through seven. Here it comes. Now a ball hit fouled off to the right side, and that just about got the first base coach. Bonnie can't hold on there as he swings and misses on a pitch in the dirt, and he's down 0-2 now. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. Throwing a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
Throw on to Gonzalez, and that's out number two.
Two more ground outs, and that's the product of throwing that sinker. Just about every time you swing at it, you're either going to hit the top of it or miss it altogether. And if you do hit it, you're going to be killing all the worms out there in front of home plate.
And a bouncing ball, foul. Here's the pitch. Right over the top with that curveball, and it's 0-2. And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes. Three up. Justin Turner will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there. And he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
I know he's been dominant all game long, and I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on, and that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
Right by him here, and he's set up for another strikeout here, the count to 0-2.
And it looks like the scouting report says, work this guy away, and it's been paying off.
And whoever put together that scouting report did a real nice job, because this whole team hasn't done much offensively at all.
Now the pitch. Adrian Gonzalez comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
Well, one thing we've seen from this guy on the mound so far, when he makes bad pitches, they typically miss out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
A high strike there, and it's 1-1. Swing and a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. No runs, no hits, and two errors thus far on the Dodger line score. And there's a pitch Gonzalez takes, and we're back even at 2-2. That's it sharply past the mound and on into center field for a one-out single. So these fans will not get to see history here after all, as the no-hit bid ends right here with one out in the eighth. Jock Peterson is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. As a look, now the pitch. And he lays off for ball one. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Swing and a miss on the sinker, and it's 1-2. Got him. as he just continues to mow down these hitters. 13 strikeouts now. Chase Utley will try it again. 0 for 2 with a fly out and a ground ball thus far. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good. Carlos Ruiz will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. And he takes ball one. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. Now a swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. And this is fouled back and out of play. Two men are on with two men out. And he's going to add to the total. 14 punch-outs now. Is that in? Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Kenley Jansen come on now to start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is for the bottom of the ninth.
Number 15.
And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Oh, he had him fooled there. No balls and two strikes.
Oh, man, what a perfect pitch right there in a perfect spot. And that's exactly how you have to attack a guy like this. He wasn't even close on that pitch.
Pitch in the dirt is swung on and missed, so he'll need to get the force at first. And the throw will indeed take care of him for the first down.
Boy, that's a really nice play there behind the plate. He doesn't panic. He takes his time and makes the good throw on the first. So score that a strikeout with a 2-3 put out for good measure.
Standing in now, Dexter Fowler. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out. Javier Baez strides in, grounded out his last time through. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Pitch on the way, and he powers the cut fastball by him that time, and he's in charge now, nothing in two. And there's strike three, so we'll see now if they can manage to hold on to this. Austin Barnes will stand in now to begin their half of the ninth in a game that was decided long, long ago.
Yep, this is mop-up time out there right now. But hey, these at-bats still count against your batting average, so you can't go up there and just mail it in. You've got to see this through right to the end of the game.
Foul back. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground towards short. And a throw on by Zobrist gets him at first for out number one. Andre Ethier will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0 for 3 thus far. First pitch is a slider called for a strike. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Tried to get him out front, but it's a ball 1-2. And with one out in the ninth, he's just now coming up on his 100th pitch of the ball game. And this ball's pulled on the ground down the line to first. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Bases are empty, one man out. And Ethier will hang around a little longer as that misses to make it 2-2 now.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Swing and a miss on a ball in the dirt as they'll need to throw down to first. And indeed, the throw will finish him off as they get the put out at first, and there are two away now.
Well, this has been a thoroughly dominating performance out there. Kept these guys guessing all game long, and he's just one out away now from picking up a well-deserved complete game shutout.
Josh Reddick will stand in now as their last shot here with two away in the ninth.
Yeah, just one final hurdle here before he finishes off the shutout.
Grounded softly to the left side. Throw on to first will be in time to get him, and the Cubs are going to take home field advantage right back. They win game three to go up 2-1 as this one is over.
Boy, what a performance of pitching that we just saw. He was so close to putting his name into the record books, but he's going to have to settle for that complete game one-hitter.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory.